Good evening, one and all. My name is Mani Anand, working as lecturer in Anna University. Actually, I want to tell about something about our university. So initially, all the engineering colleges in Tamil Nadu comes under Anna University Chennai. Right now, before 3 years back, they are separated into 4 zones. One is it in Tirunelveli, one is it in Coimbatore, another one in Trichy and Chennai. Okay. So right now we have enough 128 colleges are under our engineering colleges, and we have 4 separate campuses in Chennai itself. So actually these 4 campuses are purely autonomy, and remaining 128 colleges is affiliated to our university rules and regulations. Okay, so that is the thing. So normally regarding this computer programming, so quick things which you suggested in the email, that's why I have this stuff. Okay, so based on that, regarding this computer programming, they have 3 papers. Okay, so in the engineering of all the courses, in the autonomy of our university, we have 32 UG courses. All the UG courses taken these three courses. What are they means? They have the computer programming theory in the first semester, and also simultaneously they have the lab also. Okay, so in the theory they have only some concept regarding the computer and computer science and IT, and also problem solving and C programming, nothing more than that. In the part of lab, we have 2 labs. One is practice 1 in the first semester and practice 2 in the second semester. In the first semester, purely we talk about thing is word, spreadsheets, and some commands over there in the part of Linux and C programs. Okay, so that is the thing which we have it in the first practice, computer practice 1. In the part of second, we have purely Unix based programming, which has all the Unix commands and all the operations held in a Unix, and a little bit shell programming, and also Unix based C programming. Okay, so all those steps will be there in the part of second semester. Okay, so regarding the evaluation method, the thing is the autonomy have different evaluation method. The remaining 130 colleges have different evaluation method. Regarding our university, we are having internal assessment 50 marks and external assessment we have 50 marks. So in the internal, we are separating like this. We have 3 assessments, purely test, which is conducting for 1.5 hours. So all the questions will be around only 25 marks only per assessment. In that 3 assessments, we will take best of 2. Okay, so for 25 marks, and then the remaining 20 marks will be for observation and record note they are maintaining for entire semester. For each and everything, they are maintaining the observation. While getting the observation by showing the outputs. Okay, afterwards they will copy it in the record. So that really happens. So remaining 5 marks is purely for attendance. Okay, so we have some category because of above 75, we have 75 to 85 1 mark, and 85 to 95 2 marks, and so on. Okay, so those who are having 100% attendance, they will get 5 marks. So that is the evaluation pattern. Regarding the affiliation colleges, they have a little bit different. So 80-20, I think so. 80-20. So 80 will for so even though we have some people on it, so 80 full for external examination and 20 for internal. So regarding the external, we have some peculiarity on it. What is the thing is, each and every zone they have their own coordinating people. Okay, so the coordinating people will assign some external examiner for conducting the external examination for that 80 marks to the another colleges. So the external examiner should be from any other college in that zone. Okay, so the internal examiner will be the course instructor. So that is the mannerism they are handing it. And 20 marks, purely they have some assessment, observation and record. All those comes under, and also for attendance, they have individual separation according to the college they have it for 20 marks. So this is the thing. So and lab assignments and all normal things, all the things which we have it in. Regarding the infrastructure, which we have it in our campus, normally we have 4 separate campus. Everywhere we are using the same things, but one thing I want to tell regarding this Linux, somebody have that open source. So last 25, actually the university is framed 30 years back. Okay, actually the this our center, Ramanujan Computing Centre, is started at the age of 1965 around. So it is at the time the College of Engineering, it's called it as a College of Engineering Gindi. Before 30 years only they framed as a university, an university. Okay, so in while starting it itself, after some stage, some improvement on it, all the services, for example, any database server, mail server, web server, every services will be depend on Solaris and Linux, nothing more than that. We didn't have any Windows servers. Okay, so and also in the part of our lab oriented here, we have around 120 machines in that lab. So normally in College of Engineering Indy, we have per year we have around 8,600 students. So because we have around 26 UG programs in that, so all these will be used. So use the same lab. The server configuration, we have the Linux OS only. So we have 64 GB RAM, and regarding the client, it's very beauty. It's purely Linux, nothing else. Okay, so we have enough browsing center also. Browsing center means we have browsing machines. It's also involved in Linux. So and what are all we have it in our center. So we didn't instruct anybody right now. So right now we have it. And one more thing I want to tell, one more thing is, in our College of Engineering Indy, they have a Linux forum also. Students started 3 years back the Linux forum, where they will interact with companies like Red Hat and so on. So they will used to have some courses and some instructions for the juniors, and providing the CDs and establish over in the hostel and also in the campus. They will promoting the things of Linux, and also we are maintaining site for it also, CEG Forum Linux. Okay, and in that normally last 2 years back we put it a tabular column, where what are all the softwares involved for the curriculum of a BE computer science particularly, or IT. So comparatively, what are the softwares? We have it as a open source provided in the market, and so you can have these links. So that kind of information is given last 2 years back itself. So and regarding the assessment and all, the individual staff will be take care of it. So and one more lag of the thing is no supporting people. Okay, so only the individual staff will take care of everything. So lab instructor will be there while there is a problem with the physical components, not with the logical things. Okay, so that is the major difficulty. So each and every batch there will be around 80 to 85 students. So we have around 15 students in 15 batches in our CEG, College of Engineering Indy, but around in the four campuses we have around 22 batches. Okay, so each and every staff will be take care of its own 85 students for both the theory and also lab. While lab only, they have some assisting people, not much supporting of teaching the students and evaluating, not like that. So totally dumped with that particular faculty. So that is the one drawback which we feel it. And one more thing is regarding the evaluation, we have 50 marks internal assessment. So we want to conduct the test regularly. So three assessments will be there. So that assessments will be really just distribute the questions and ask them to do it and evaluate while seeing the outputs. That's all. Nothing what we called complex, or we can have some nothing challenge regarding the students. They will do the exercise and we will assess it based on that. Okay. So and nothing else on. I have all the hard copies for sample questions and lab exercise, and I want to show it. So all these are, for example, it's a small lab exercise Unix. So verifying the following using Unix commands and demonstrate LC.
If after going back, if you find soft copies also, and if you can mail I'll them, that will be nice.
Sure, sir.
Because we would like to compile this information. Sure. And secondly, have you, or for that matter, anybody else tried automatic evaluation of the code that is submitted by the students? NCST had developed that kind of testing. In fact, when NCST ran a diploma program, the course that they gave on programming, the marks you got were either 0 or 1 for an assignment. And the important thing was that your program must run. So you submit your program by testing and whatever, then they would have an automated testing system for which they will prepare the input data and the output data that is required for a particular program specification. And they will simply take your program, it will get compiled, it will get executed, it will take data from this system, push data out and tell you whether the program is working or not. Which one? Mushak. Oh, I see. Which contest? ACM contest. Okay. Oh, then Professor Shivkumar should be aware of this. So why not we suggest that we should start using it?
So similarly, IBM Great Minds also following that same concept. IBM conducting a challenging program, Great Minds.
If for the next 2 days, you can search the link and give it to us, we'll just examine that. Maybe I'll start using it for my own course immediately. Yes. Okay.